Excuses aren't real. Humans make them up to stay small. And when you stay small, you stay safe, but you never grow, you never take risks, and you compromise what your dream is.
And Erica, you're an absolute rocket ship. I mean, you bring the fire, you bring the heat, you bring the enthusiasm.
The more authentic my relationships became, the more sincere my success was.
I underwent a lot of loss. It's chapter one, everyone, if you get the book.
The truth is, to be an influencer, you can't be easily swayed. You've got to stand on your own two feet, choosing the best version of you no matter who you meet. So when people say, what do you do for a living? Do you whisper and hope they won't judge you? Or do you claim yourself? Because that's the only way they're ever going to really love you and grudge you, because they can't do the same and they feel trapped and you're the easiest to blame.
So many of us are like, this person made me mad. That person didn't make you mad, you made you mad. Because whatever the person said, you assigned all the meaning to it, you made it mean whatever it is that you made it mean, and now you're mad. So that person's words did not stop you from doing whatever it was you were going to do. You stopped you.
I don't want to be perfect and admired. I would rather be real, authentic, and loved.
The way that I always recommend to do it is put a little out there and listen.
Yeah.
See what your audience is telling you that they want. What should you create based on what they're asking for?
Check in with yourself and figure out, is the idea or brand or whatever it is that you want to create, is it signature? Have you compromised, and are you passionate about it?
Create what your perfect day looks like. Like, what does that everyday perfect day look like? And of course, they're not all gonna turn out that way, but then you have an aim for a quality life and not a quality goal. You don't find a bird in a river, you don't find a fish in the sky, and that's because a bird is gonna drown if it hops into the river, and a fish is going to fall and die if it's anywhere near the sky. And it was insinuating that human beings are often the only animal in the world who can both drown and go to their day jobs at the same time. So it was really a testament to how natural it actually is to pursue your purpose.
What are you already doing that is working, and how can you slowly morph that and integrate that into what you're passionate about? Because I think everyone is full of ideas, and when the idea meets, you know, the right timing, then the opportunity is created.